Hi friends, this is Amit Kumar and I welcome to my channel Prince Tech Solutions. Today I am going to show you how to create a first visualization layer in ClickSense. So if you remember, in the last session we have created a connectivity to database. We have used a database as MS Excel, and then we created a data model. And on top of that data model, I am going to create a very simple and interactive dashboard today as a starter. So let's take a tour on this. In the last session, we have created this first ClickSense applications. So this is the first ClickSense application we have created. And this is one sheet I've created. I am going to create a new sheet for the training today. So let me take you to the last creativity, what we created. You can see the data load editor here. We have loaded the table files. Let's see what we have loaded. We have an Excel file, which is in this location. This is the Excel file. Let's plot it. Okay, so this is product DB, and you can see the the fields, which is common in this three tables. I'm going to open this one. Yeah, so I have three tables. One is customer, then this is product and transaction. So you can see these three tables are here to be connected to each other to form a database schema. You can see in the first table we have customer code, which is the unique ID of this table. Whereas in transaction table we have also customer code. So based on these two key fields, we can connect this transaction with the customer. So likewise, product, we have product code, which is the primary key of this table, and here we can consider this is the foreign key of this table. So based on these two common attributes, we can connect these three tables together. Okay, now let's go to the ClickSense editor. We have loaded this three table. And here this is the key field cost code, which is customer table's unique ID, and here in the transaction table it is also there. Likewise, the product code and product code, which is there in the transaction table. So based on this only, I could create the data model. And if you want to see the this data model viewer, you can see these three tables are connected to each other based on those concerned key fields. Now this is the data. Alright. Now we'll use this small data model and we'll create some visualizations. So I just have to came here to create a new sheet. This is App Overview. App Overview is a window where we can create the new sheets, which is our visualization layer. And Data Manager, Data Load Editor, Data Manager, if you want to create, if you want to connect to a new data sheet, you have to go here and then create a connection. And while you're loading the data sheet, and if you're doing any changes in the data sheet, you have to go to Data Editor, Data Load Editor, and Data Model Viewer is the view of your data model in a graphical form. Okay, so I'm going to create a new analysis here, create a new sheet. So individual sheets are here considered to be individual dashboards in ClickSense. So I'll just create a new sheet here. I will give the name as order analysis. Okay, click here. Now I'll have to go inside this to create some analysis. This sheet is completely empty. If you want to do any changes here, it itself is prompting click edit on the right top to start editing on the sheet, so that we can add any number of KPIs, any number of visualizations, any fields. So first of all, my task is to edit this sheet. Okay. Now on the left side menu, you can see the list of the charts available in ClickSense. There are various charts like bar chart, combo chart, filters, gauge, KPIs and all. So I will take you to all these charts one by one. And you can also see the fields, those we have added to the data model, and they are also segregated by tables. Here there are three tables. You can also filter those fields by tables. I can choose customer master. I will see only the customer master's table, and so on. And if you do not choose anything, all tables, you can be able to see the all tables information. So first of all, I will add few charts and few filters, and in that filter I will have to add few columns. Okay, first of filter I have to add is, I can simply drag it here to the left side. So this is a grid view of the layout, and its design here in the ClickSense is extremely easy. So one, I have filter pane. So in the filter pane, you can add a dimension. So I'm going to add here the dimension as customer. Customer name is a filter here. I'll just change it. This changes will not be impacted to the database field. It is just changing and the caption of the customer here, you know, the filter. So this become my first filter. The second filter I'll also add likewise. Add dimension and choose here product. Here we go. We have the product. Okay, so there are two filters I've added. Now it's time to add some KPI. Now what is KPI? Let me tell you, KPI is key performance indicator. So any object, any any chart or any graphics which gives you some information to take decision, that's what we call as a key performance indicator. So while I'm dragging, the layout is automatically be taking, like whether you want to change it to a vertical layout or a horizontal layout. So as per your preference, you can drag and choose here. You can also choose the full screen. Okay, so the specification of the bar chart is minimum one dimension you can add and one measure is required. Now before I go to dimension and measure, let me tell you guys what is a dimension and what is a measure. This is applicable for the freshers who do not understand the dimensions. So in a geometry, if you remember in your school days, you should have a bar charts or any small chart where you need a x-axis and y-axis. So basically, if I say in a layman term, the most of the fields, those are in text type of data, those are in string type of data, they used to be shown in the x-axis, whereas the fields, those are in numerics, they can be calculated mathematically on by sum, by average, by minimum and maximum, they will be there in the y-axis. So they are usually measures, and dimensions are usually the text type or string type of data which used to be shown in the x-axis of the chart. Okay, so now I have to choose a dimension, and here it will prompt me to choose the field from the data model. So I'll just choose the first dimension is the customer, and then the measure. I'll have to choose, measure has to be sum of, it has to be aggregated field. Okay, so I can choose sum of sales. COGS is my cost of goods sales, so it's actually sales value. I'll choose it. It is a sum of sales. Now you can change the field captions here on the chart. So while you're selecting this one, you have this customer name and there's a label here. Okay, inside that there's a label here. You can choose it as a customer in the label, so it would be changing in the chart. And the second field, which is measure, you can change in the label here. It is, I'm just giving it as a sales. I should not show it as sum of sales. I'll just name it as simple cells. Now this become my simple bar chart. Now there are also many more fields to show here, include null values. If there are few null values which is showing here, you can uncheck this one, so there will be a reference to be shown. And so I'm showing no limitations. No limitations means all the values to be shown, and the rest of the values, the rest of the customers, those are not able to be accommodated inside this small screen. They will be shown in the scroll. Sorting, add-ons, appearance. There are many more fields to go. So there's a presentation field. You can choose the chart type, whether it is a vertical orientation or a horizontal orientation. So let's say vertical is my preference. The presentation color and legend, you can choose the chart color, which is blue here, and it's taking auto color. Instead of auto color, you can choose the multicolor also. Okay, you can choose your own color. If you want to give it as a single color instead of this blue, you can change it to anything, whether it is a red, whether it is orange or anything. Okay, if you don't want to make it as a single color, if you want to make it discrete color by customer or discrete color by sales, okay, you can also show it. So there are two differences here: color by dimension and color by measure. If you show color by dimension, dimension can be calculated by any values, as I said. So it would be shown in a discrete color like this. Okay, so these are all the discrete colors. Now if you want to choose this by measure, so all these values, all these colors will be based on a single color, and the color density will be gradually increasing and decreasing based on the volume of the data. So you see here, this is basically higher value which turn into darker in color, and this is lower value which is turn into the lighter in color, and so on to the smaller value. Okay, this is how the this thing is calculated, and you can choose the types from the which is available in the these palettes. Now I'm not going to choose it by the color by measure. I'll choose it by dimension. Now let it be. So there are two palettes available here. This is first palette which is consist of 12 colors. This is second palette which consists of 100 colors. So if there are 50 values, the colors will be applied from here to here. And here, if it is a 12, if you choose this palette, the rest of the colors after 12 will be repeated again from this. Okay, so this is what it is. So legends, I am able to show here the legends on the right side based on the colors. So however, I don't want to show the legends also. If you don't want, then you can uncheck this one. So legends has gone up. If you make it automatic, so legend title, I'm showing here the legend title which is customer name. I don't want the legend title as well as the any legend also. Okay, I just uncheck because I can see the customer names right here and their colors, so no need to show the legends. Labels and titles. So like this, there are many properties. I'll just go one by one to them. And this is, here we go, we have created a first bar chart with linear color. Okay, now I'll just change the title of this. I can change the title with some minimum full name based on the dimension and measure. I can give the name as customer wise sales. Okay. So this is what I can say here, the scale. Scale means in which scale the values to be shown on our repetitions. If you want to make it narrow, they will be shown in narrow. If you show in wide, there is only one value showing here. if there are a lot of values, it would be swing narrow, means there would be a lot of fragmentations will come up here. Okay, so this is all about the bar chart. It's a very simple bar chart. I can save it and then I can go for the combo chart, which is the next one. I will simply drag it for the combo chart. And what the combo chart is, why is the name it so? Combo, combo means it's a combination of two different type of charts. One is a bar chart, second is a line chart. So as there are two different charts is going to be shown in a single panel, it needs one dimension and two measures. I repeat, it needs one dimension and two measures to create a combo chart. So that one dimension, which would be show the captions of the chart, and two measures, the first measure will be show the x value, and the y measure will show the second measure will be showing the y value, and both will be differently visualized. One would be bar and second would be line. So let's add this one to see how it is looks like. Add a dimension. I'm going to take the first dimension, which is say product. This is going to be the product name. So I will first, my first task is to change the product label. The database field is product name, whereas I can just change it and this. And the first measure I have to add, which is sales. I can choose this as the sum of sales. And the second one you have to add here, alternative measure, which is revenue, sum of revenue. Now here in the appearance, you can go ahead with this in general. I'll have to check it here. Then the first in the data, there are two things. One is product, second one is customer. In the customer, second one is sales. So I'll have to change this first, the label, and this is the first measure. I can choose this as bar, and this is the second measure. I can choose this as line. Okay, so this is basically first measure I have added, and there is an option I have chosen as bar. The type would be bar chart. The second measure which I have selected, the type is become a line. Now this has to be shown in the primary axis or in the secondary axis. You have to take a call here. So I'll just take it as a secondary axis here. This become a bar. Let me just delete this one, and then let me add the second measure. This one is, instead of this revenue, by adding in the alternative dimension, I have to add it as a here. I have measure is sales. Another measure I'll have to add is revenue, not an alternative measure, in the measure list only. So revenue I have added. It the type of the this thing would be type of the thing would be function would be sum. So I will choose this as a revenue. Okay, now this become, I'll just choose this as a line chart. The first measure I'll choose this as a bar chart. Now what I'll do, there is the option called primary and secondary. So I just chosen the second measure, which is I selected as a line chart. This is revenue. I just take it to secondary axis, and the first measure which I have selected as a bar chart, I took it as a primary axis. So you can see in this bar chart we have one axis in the x-axis, this is y-axis, and this is z-axis. You can consider logically, or you can say this is primary x-axis, primary y-axis, and secondary y-axis right here. So there is no secondary y-axis in the bar chart, whereas in the combo chart we have secondary y-axis. I also shown them in a line chart. So if you just choose the secondary axis in bar also, how it would be shown? It would be shown like this. It would be shown in side by side series. Okay. However, I just try to show them in line, so it is looking nice. So there's a comparison, and it makes sense. Combo chart. So it's a combination of two different charts. So sales amount, how do you want to show them, in which format it is asking here. If you don't want to have the decimal values, you can uncheck, like remove like this. And for revenue as well, the number formatting, if you don't want to show the, it is showing 1000 separator. I just could remove this thing also, the decimal values, then I could remove it. I can only see the 1000 separator values. Okay, so there are two values I have added. Now it's time to make it a little bit colorful. And what are the properties available here? Let's have a look into this. In the presentation, so data points, so that in the lines, in the line chart, you'll be having some data points. And this one value here, this is one product which has sales is zero, but still it is showing. So what I can do here in the data, in the product, you can include null values, which is included. You can exclude this. So what will happening here? The sales, the product which has the null value, it would be removed. So what I did here, I have excluded this. I just added limitation to remove that values. It was showing the products, those measures, the sales. It is calculated on sales. So whose sales is greater than or equal to zero, then it would be sold. But I just add a condition that if the sales is greater than zero, then only it would be, that product would be sold, or else it would be invisible. All right, now it's what all about the data. Let's go for a small appearance, and then we will give this dashboard as a final touch. I have this color and legend. Go to color legend instead of this auto colors. So legends, which is off, I just could remove this one. And legend was showing, I don't want to show this legend title. Okay, so that's why I just could remove this one. And then legend position, if it is showing right, if it is showing button, if you want to show in the button also you can. So I just could add it to the button, or if you want to show in the top also you can show it. So I think bottom will be the better option to show the legends. And then here the color, instead of the single color, if you want to show it to the multicolor also, you can show it. And okay, this color looks good to me. I just could choose, this is basically showing the blue color, which is the startup, and then the second axis is a purple color. And here this should be the startup and this should be the end, so which is showing a red color and green colors mixture. So I am least bothered about this coloring, so this this looks nice here. X is continuous label. So there are a few more properties you can deal play with that and give the final touch to this values. So this is pretty much about to create a small visualization in the ClickSense. So let's see, stop editing and let's see how it is showing in the customer view. So this is how it is showing in the customer view. I can see it's showing in much beautiful way. There's a bar chart and there are filters. If I select this customer, I can see this getting filtered customer wise products. If you want to choose this customer wise data also, you can select them and then click OK. So the selection has been mapped here. You don't want to do this also. If you don't want to select this customer and if you want to remove this filter, just click this one. Then the selection, which was 5 out of 40, gone removed. I again will remove this. There's a difference between the selection of the ClickSense and ClickView. In ClickView, we were supposed to choose control button to select multiple objects from the list box, whereas this is pretty easy. You can select them and then either you can deselect or choose it finally to apply a filter. I just chosen them. So I just could add a few customer in the list, and based on those customer I can see the listed products and their sales. So if you want to remove the sales also, those products, just the selection which is mapped here, you can remove it. So one more filter if you'll add here, I just selected the product, and then that filter category is again added to this filter panel. This is what the filter panel here. And here all the items I am just going for filtration, they are listing here. You can remove them one by one if you don't want to keep it in the filters. Okay, now it is showing all the item irrespective of any filtration. So thank you so much. It is pretty much from the for the beginners. So in the next videos I will bring some advanced level analytics based on the different visualizations. So if you like my video, please like and subscribe in the YouTube channel you're showing below. Thank you so much.